said, I want you to go up, downstairs, and cook breakfast for the children. I looked at her clock. I said, dear, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. She said, exactly. Go downstairs and cook breakfast for the children. They have to go to school. I said, well, to eat at 6 o'clock, isn't that bad for your stomach? I mean, they just ate 12 hours ago. She said, we'll get out of that bed and go downstairs and cook breakfast for your children. I said, well, I don't know what they want to eat. It's down there. I'll get out of my bed. I said, well, where are the pans? Do we have pans to cook with? She said, Brill, get out of bed. I'm going to have another thought to a question. It's so early. I'm going to shock. I'll get the shotgun out of the closet and blow your face off. I said, well, there's no need to be violent about this. So I fell back to sleep again. And the next thing I knew, there was a bucket of ice water being shaken over my head. And this woman, she's just standing up on me like this. Now you get up! I'm gonna wear this bucket of ice water! I said, you're serious, aren't you? So I got up. I went downstairs and I was talking to myself. I go breakfast for sand in the pants now. Bam! I'm still there. Get the bacon and the sausage and boom! And then you have to be careful with eggs. Got to cook breakfast. Cool! First one down was the 4-year-old child, little beautiful face, clean, little brain, little thing. Come on, Daddy. I said, what do you want for breakfast? Now, a 4-year-old has the ability to see through and find the wrong thing. And she saw what was behind me. She saw the chocolate cake. She said, can I have the chocolate cake? I said, chocolate cake? Where? She said, well, the chocolate cake behind you. And I looked, and there was the chocolate cake. The child wanted chocolate cake for breakfast. How ridiculous. And I said, but then, something got my brain. Read the ingredients for chocolate cake. Eggs are a chocolate cake, and milk, oh goody, and wheat, that's nutrition. So I said, what do you want? He said, can I have a chocolate cake? I said, chocolate cake, coming up. 10 more slices, got the cake for her, and served it. Now, you need something to drink with this, something breakfast. Grape juice. So I gave them grape juice, and then I didn't have to cook. Then the one of the four came down. You know what? Like when you go like, they got in the kitchen. Child eating chocolate cake. He looked at me and said, Dad, where'd you get the chocolate cake? He went to the child and said, how'd you get chocolate cake? The child said, Dad, give me chocolate cake. And they said to me, Father, could we have chocolate cake? father said, "Chocolate cake coming up! Dinner in 4 slices.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Dinner in cake, and then dinner in the grape juice. And the 5 children were sitting at breakfast. And the morning dinner wait. And a chocolate cake. And singing to me, Daddy's great. Because it's a shock cake. And we had a ball. Until. My wife came down looking like this. And she saw what the children were eating. Now, I've heard of someone having a conniption, but I never saw one. You don't want to see him. My wife's face split. My hair was split and fell off, and there was nothing except the skull. Then Warren's wife lit all around her hair, and fire shot from her eye sockets, burning my stomach. And she said, "Where did you get that chocolate cake from?" I said, "They asked for it." Then the children who were singing praises to me lied on me. They said, "We asked for eggs and milk. But Dad made us eat this." And my wife sent me to my room, which is where I wanted to go in the first place. You see, we are dumb, but we are not so dumb. It takes great work thinking to keep from working.